Okay, now let's take a closer look at the ovary. Now the ovary of the tomato, in this cartoon anyway, looks just like one structure. But like so many other parts of flowers, instead of it really being one structure, it's actually the result of fusion of more than one carpel. We talked about fusion in this lesson and in the last one about flower structure a couple of times, and it just means that instead of plant parts being independent, they can be connected together in some areas. And so this is an example of where the tomato ovary is actually made up of not one carpel, but of several carpels, three or maybe four, fused together. The actual number depends upon the variety of tomato. So if we were to take a look at this ovary, it would not be just one carpel, but several of them fused together. And it might have a bit of a gnarly look as a result of that. So, see if I can make it just look a little bit better. If we took a blown up picture of this carpel, so this is this part, you would have not just one, but three or four of these carpels fused tightly together. If we looked inside of the carpel, what we would see is a chamber in the carpel. Actually, more than one chamber in the carpel, and each chamber represents one of those carpels that was connected together. So inside we'd see several chambers. And these chambers are called locules, L-O-C-U-L-E-S, locules. So I'm going to put, just to make it easier to see, that's the solid outside wall of the carpel. Then we have these chambers inside, which are the locules. Inside the chambers are ovules. And these ovules are where the female gametes are housed and are awaiting the pollen that's going to come down the stigma and style and fertilize the female gamete. So this is the ovule, and this stalk is called the funiculus. And the middle area from which the stalk grows is called the placenta. Now the reason I'm showing you all this detail is, remember, a fruit is formed from the ripened ovary wall, and these ovules after fertilization will be where the seeds are formed. So this part will become eventually the fruit. So if that's the case, when we cut open a tomato fruit, we should be able to see these structures reflected in the fruits.